Welcome back to Brewers Fantasy Camp Confidential here with Jonathan Lucroy. First time camper? Rookie?
Yeah, I'm a rookie camper. Happy to be here. And I'll be on the mound today throwing. I recommend not watching.
I was going to say, as a rookie camper, I feel like there's got to be something because, you know, Rillo and Vonnie and all these guys have been here for a while. I'm sure they have some rookie things for you to do.
Yeah, basically they're like, yeah, you're going to be the pitcher. And, you know, I could barely throw the ball whenever I was catching, so much less pitching. I haven't pitched since I was 12. So, it should be interesting, guys.
What's been your first impression of camp?
It's fun. I mean, look, a lot of guys like that fun, love baseball, love the Brewers, love being, you know, being around that. I love being back on the field and doing stuff, and it's always fun to get back and, you know, come around and just be involved. I mean, it's, you know, anytime we get back on the field, it's a huge blessing, especially here in beautiful Arizona, so it's really fun.
Yeah, that's one of the things I kind of gather with talking, not just with the camper, but the coaches. It's kind of getting back with your old teammates, getting back in the locker room mentality, and you guys just seem like you're having a blast out here.
We really are. I mean, look, it's just a bunch of guys that love baseball, love playing, and love having fun. I mean, that's what it's all about. I mean, it's a really cool thing, and I've always heard that fantasy camps are great. You know, Rock's always told me how awesome these things are, so happy I could join this year.
When we talk about awesome, we have to talk about 2011, right? I mean, that 2011 Brewers team was absolutely loaded. I mean, that was your rookie year, sophomore year?
No, that was my second year.
Second year, yeah, sophomore year. So, I mean, you think of the pitching staff with Greinke and Gallardo and Markham, who was just stellar that season, and then just talent all over the place. That was, what, 12 years ago now? That's crazy to think.
Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, I feel like I just broke into the big leagues in 2010, you know, so it's really cool. Like I said, that it flies by really fast and you miss it. And it's always, like I said, it's always good to get back out, kind of keep stoking the fire of just being on the field and being around the players and, you know, and doing, you know, I'm here, I do minor league stuff as well with the minor leaguers. And so it's really cool just to be around them and just special for me as a player coming to give back to the organization, and hopefully we can win a World Series one day.
What's your fondest memory of that 2011 team? Because you were, what, two games away from World Series?
Yeah, two wins, yeah. It was, you know, a lot of good memories. I mean, that was, I feel like I was spoiled, you know, my first full season in the big leagues. And I'm on literally one of the greatest teams in Brewer history. And it was just really special and really great, really cool experience. And I'm very grateful for that. And I think about it a lot. And I think about the celebrations we had, everything from the plane rides we had, everything, just the veterans we had on that team. It was just a really special time, and I'll never forget it.
I think Brewers fans will never forget that Niger Morgan base hit up in the middle of the NLDS.
J.J. Putz. I'll never forget it. I'll never forget J.J. Putz. And it was Niger. I love Niger's my boy, and I hope he's doing well. But, yeah, a great team. Everyone contributed up and down the lineup. We had some really, really tough dudes on that team and just veteran guys that have been around a long time. And that was probably the biggest year I ever had for just learning and being able to soak up knowledge from these guys. And I feel very fortunate that I was able to do that. I really feel like I know it impacted the rest of my career.
Who'd you learn the most from?
I learned a lot from Hoffy, LaTroy Hawkins, Prince, Ricky, how to play the game, how to play the game the right way, just being a professional, being a grinder, fighting every day, competing. There's just so many different lessons that you can go up and down the list. I can't even name them all, but like I said, being around the right guys like that early in my career was just very, very, very blessed for that, and to be able to have that, and very fortunate.
Well, Jonathan, thanks so much, man. Appreciate it.
Hey, thanks for having me.